Welcome to my class, Threads of E-commerce Security. We all are started to business online. We started to purchase online. Security threats are the most important obstacle while doing e-commerce. Merchants are facing threats against security of their valuable information, documents transacted over the internet. As well as consumers are also fear about online transfer of money by giving credit card information, personal information, that is mainly because of lack of security. In order to succeed, highly competitive e-commerce environment, business organization must have to taken more sophisticated technology to overcome security threats, and thereby we can win customer trust. First of all, let us see what are the different types of e-commerce threats. We all know what is the meaning of e-commerce security. E-commerce security, here I mean protection of electronic assets from unauthorized access, use, alteration or destruction. Then the first type of e-commerce security threat, that is hacking. Hacking means gaining unauthorized access to a computer system or a network, either by breaking password or illegally obtaining passwords. This is the first threat. Sometimes anybody, attacker, can easily access to our computer and steal all the personal information or break our computer system. So this type of unauthorized access to the network, to the computer system, by breaking our password, that is known as hacking. Second point is spoofing. Spoofing means it is the act of disguising communication from an unknown source as a known or trusted source. It can be applied to emails, phone calls, websites, or can be more technical. In this picture, we can see there are two persons. One is customer or user, another one is attacker, hijacker. Then the user browse one website, but unknowingly it moves to fake website, malicious website. That is the influence of the attacker. This type of threat is known as spoofing. For example, here on the right side you can see Amazon website. When we move to Amazon website, our browser moves to the spoofed website URL, that is Amazon. Spelling of Amazon is changing and a fake website is created by the attacker. Then we are unknowingly moving to the fake website. Then we can lose our personal information, credit card number, password, everything. Then third one is phishing. Phishing our personal data. It's a fraudulent practice. It is done through emails, telephone, text message. As reputable entities, this call from, we may see a lot of info, news related with this type of phishing. As call from bank, please provide your ATM OTP number, like that. Then when we give that OTP number, that makes to lose our full amount from our account. That means it's a fraudulent practice by using telephone, by using email or text message as from reputable entities for what? To reveal the personal information such as our password, credit card number, etc. This is known as phishing. Then fourth point is farming. Farming is scamming practice in which malicious codes is installed on a personal computer. For what purpose? For misdirecting user to fraudulent website without knowing their knowledge or consent. That means redirecting a website traffic to another fake site. That is known as farming. We type the genuine website address amazon.com, but our web browser redirect the traffic to the fake site that is known as farming. Next is flashing. Flashing means permanent denial of service attack. This damage our system so that we can replace or reinstall the hardware system, everything. Permanent damage of the hardware or software, that is known as flashing. Then next is web hijacking. Here the attacker take the forceful control over a person's website and thereby denying the owner's control over his website by cracking the password. We all heard about plane hijacking. Likewise, here website is hijacked by the attacker by taking the owner's full control by cracking the password. Seventh one is denial of service attack. This is a distributed denial of service attack. This is a malicious attempt to disrupt the normal traffic. That means this attack is like a traffic jam clogging up with highway, preventing regular traffic from arriving at its desired destination. In a network, we can't reach the destination because of the heavy traffic jam. That type of attack is known as denial of service attack. Just to see the pictures, we can see the regular traffic, but it is they can't reach at the destination. That is mainly because of the artificial traffic jam created by the attacker. That is known as denial of service. Next we see malicious code software. Malicious software means malicious, dangerous programs is created to harm or to harm the system or network. Internet-based software is designed to disrupt the network or harm the computer. These are the different names of malicious software. One is virus. Virus is the program capable of infecting other programs. Then worms is also a virus, but it is spread from one computer to another computer as our corona. Then third one is Trojan virus. This is a program that acts as useful, but later on gaining control over the computer and causes damage to the computer. That means this Trojan horse came as a user-friendly one, but later it gained control over our system and make damage to our computer. Spyware. Spyware is malicious software that is installed unknowingly without the user permission. Then how it is installed? While installing other programs, it is unknowingly came to our system and make some disruption. That is known as spy working software. Then next is adware, that is related with advertisement. This software is containing on advertisement that collect information about the user in order to display advertisements in the web browser. It is hidden in the our web browser and collect all the informations and attitude of the user, what type of websites they are watching, what are the different types of products they are browsing. Then we get that type of the related type of advertisements. This is known as adware. So malicious software examples: virus, worms, Trojan horse, spyware, adware. Every day we can see different types of malicious software in network. Then next is man in the middle attack. Here in between the user and the server, we can see a hidden man, that is known as attacker. The attacker came in between victim and the web server and give different types of communication to the parties, both to the victim, both to the server. When victim or user need some information, but the attacker misdirect the route of the information and give return back the wrong information to the user. This is a style of network attack where the attacker secretly and invisibly relay or alter the communication between two parties. Then next is spam. Spam, we all heard about the term spam. In our Gmail account, we can see a separate folder, inbox, outbox, save, like that. We can see one spam folder. In that folder, we can see lot of irrelevant advertisement messages are there. All these messages are sent over the internet to a large number of users for the purpose of advertisement, phishing, spreading malware, etc. It affects not only the security of the website but also damage to the website speed. That is the main problem. Website speed is reduced with the type of spam messages. Then bad bots. Bad bots is malicious software. These are mainly used by cyber criminals engaged in various illegal activities, just like stealing content from the website, for example, product review, breaking news, product pricing information, catalogs, user-generated content on community forums, and so on. When they make thousands of page visits within a very short span of time, it strains the web server, choke the availability bandwidth, and slowing down the site for genuine users. The main purpose of bad bots is slow down the website, reduce the bandwidth, network speed is coming down, and the genuine users could not get the website content in a normal speed. Then next is brute force attack. Here the attacker submit many passwords to get the correct one. The attacker systematically check all possible passwords until the correct one is found. Here in this picture we can see one automated system is developed by the attacker to check the password, the correct password, by trying all related type of possible passwords. This is known as brute force attack. Then 13th point is SQL injection. Injecting the SQL queries, query to the database, that helps to collect the unauthorized access of the information from our system. This is the placement of malicious code in the SQL statements, that is web page input. This is the most common web hacking technique, that is SQL injections. Then these are the e-commerce security threats. Let's summarize: hacking, spoofing, phishing, flashing, farming, web hijacking, denial of service attack, malicious software, man in the middle attack, spam, bad bots, brute force attack, SQL injections. I think all of you get a well idea about e-commerce threats.